Now the third problem, let u in the Cartesian coordinates be a harmonic function in a region omega. Then show that f of z equals dou u by dou x minus I into dou u by dou y is analytic in omega. So given u is a harmonic function, a harmonic function in omega, let f of z equals dou u by dou x minus I into dou u by dou y. So now we have to prove this function is analytic in omega. So to show f of z is analytic in omega. So just for simplified notation purpose, we shall take dou u by dou x as capital U and minus dou u by dou y as capital V. So take dou u by dou x as capital U and minus dou u by dou y as capital V. So which are the real and imaginary parts of F. So then F takes the form u plus iv. So as u is given to be a harmonic function, so u is real valued, so dou u by dou x and dou u by dou y are real numbers. So u, capital U is a real number, capital V is a real number, so u plus iv will be a complex number. So what it means, f is a complex valued function of a complex variable. So now recall the definition of an analytic function. So an analytic function is a complex valued function of a complex variable which is differentiable wherever it is defined, and we have some necessary and sufficient condition. So what is a sufficient condition for a function to be analytic, or what are the conditions that function has to satisfy in order to become an analytic function? So the conditions are, a function, a complex valued function of a complex variable is said to be analytic if the real and imaginary parts are continuous together with their partial derivatives of first order, and the real and imaginary parts has to satisfy CR equation. So these are the two conditions so that a function has to satisfy to be an analytic function. So the first condition is the real and imaginary parts has to be continuous and their first order partial derivatives has to be continuous. All the first order partial derivatives of u and v are continuous. And the second condition is u and v must satisfy CR equation. So these are the two sufficient conditions for a function to be analytic. So now we shall verify one by one. Okay, first, so what first was, note that the real and imaginary parts are continuous, right? Why? So what are the real and imaginary parts? So they are capital U and capital V. So capital U and capital V are nothing but first order partial derivatives of U, where U is harmonic. So U is a harmonic function means U is continuous and the partial derivatives of first two orders, that is first order and second order, are continuous. So as capital U and capital V denote the first order partial derivatives of the harmonic function U, they are obviously continuous. So clearly capital U and capital V are continuous on omega, the region omega. So now come to the first order partial derivatives of u and v. Also, so what is the first order partial derivative of u? So it is dou by dou x of dou u by dou x, which is dou square u by dou x square. And one more first order partial derivative of u is dou u by dou y, which is dou by dou y of dou square u by dou y, sorry. So in place of u, what I have to take? So it is dou u by dou x. So it is dou square u by dou x. So these two are first order partial derivative of u. And what are they? They are nothing but second order partial derivative of the harmonic function u. So as u is harmonic, its second order partial derivatives are continuous, and first order partial derivative of capital U are continuous. So which are continuous? Similarly, in the same way, the first order partial derivatives of capital V, so dou V by dou X and dou V by dou Y. You can observe those two will be in terms of second order partial derivatives of the harmonic function U, hence they are also continuous. So they will be continuous. So now what it remains? So we observed that the real and imaginary parts of F are continuous and the first order partial derivatives of they are also continuous. So now just it remains to verify CR equations. So we have to verify CR equations for the real and imaginary parts U and V. So what are they? So now just it remains. Now it remains to verify CR equations for the real and imaginary parts U and V. Okay, so what are CR equations? That is, we have to prove dou u by dou x is dou v by dou y, and dou u by dou y is minus dou v by dou x. So this is what we have to verify. So first we shall start with dou u by dou x. Now consider dou u by dou x. It is dou by dou x of, so what is capital U? It is dou u by dou x. So it is dou square u by dou x square. So now what we have to prove? We have to prove it to be dou v by dou y. So that means on the right hand side, we need partial derivative in terms of y. So we have to convert this into partial derivative of y. So for that, since u is harmonic, so it has to satisfy the Laplace equation. What is the Laplace equation? So dou square u by dou x square plus dou square u by dou y square has to be equal to zero. So it implies dou square u by dou x square will be, so take this to the right hand side, it will be minus dou square u by dou y square. So if I use this substitution, this will be nothing but minus dou square u by dou y square. So I'll rewrite this as dou by dou y of minus dou u by dou y. So what is it? So minus dou u by dou y is nothing but capital V. So it will be equal to dou v by dou y. So that is, we proved dou u by dou x is dou v by dou y. Now the other equation. Also consider dou u by dou y. It is dou by dou y of u is dou u by dou x. So it is dou square u by dou y dou x. Now on the right hand side, what we need? We need dou v by dou x. So just you have to interchange the partial derivatives. So as u is harmonic, the second order partial derivatives are continuous, hence the mixed derivatives are equal. So that is, since the second order partial derivatives of u are continuous, the mixed derivatives are equal. Mixed derivatives are equal. That is dou square u by dou y dou x will be nothing but dou square u by dou x dou y. So these two are called mixed derivatives of second order. Whenever the second order partial derivatives are continuous, so these two mixed derivatives will be one nothing but one and the same. So dou square u by dou y dou x can be written as dou square u by dou x dou y. So it can be written as dou by dou x of dou u by dou y. But what we need on the right hand side, we need minus dou v by dou x. So according to that, we shall rewrite this as, so we know that minus dou u by dou y is v. So just to adjust the minus, so the right hand side can be written as minus dou by dou x of minus dou u by dou y. So minus to minus, once again it will be plus, and this can be rewritten as dou by minus dou by dou x of v. So that is we proved that dou u by dou y equals minus dou v by dou x. So which means the real and imaginary parts of f, that is capital U and capital V, are continuous together with their first order partial derivatives and also satisfy CR equations. So which forms a sufficient condition for a function to be analytic. So that means the function f satisfies a sufficient condition to be an analytic function. So just we shall conclude. So thus function f of z equals dou u by dou x minus I into dou u by dou y is an analytic function in omega. So which completes the third problem.